stars, great teams, and incredible memories pave the road to the Final Four.
Jordan! Michael Jordan! Oh, he threw it to the wrong man! He threw it to Worthy!
Over.
You can see the time. Wittenberg! Oh, it's a long way! Oh,
they won it! On the dunk!
The man that he's hugging, Freddie Brown.
Smart takes the shot! Oh. Indiana wins the championship!
To Leitner. Puts it up.
Yes! The comeback pass cannot be denied. He has reinstated the magic at Michigan State.
Lee shot blocked, and Syracuse is your national champion.
UConn's the national champion for 2004.
The season premiere of NCAA college basketball on CBS. The 24th row to the Final Four on CBS starts today here in Chapel Hill between Kentucky and North Carolina. Craig Bowler-Jack along with Billy Packer, so glad you are along for the ride. And Billy, hard to believe, but 4 months from today, they will crown a champion in St. Louis.
Don't be surprised if either one of these clubs or both aren't there in St. Louis. We took a look at the all-time winningest teams. Can you get any better than this? Number one versus number two in all-time wins.
And Billy, let's take a look at the singular raising the bar game analysis.
Rashad McCants, he's a guy who had the low point of his illustrious career against Kentucky last year. He's off to a great start this year. Elite coaches, Tubby and Roy, hey, when they know you by one name, you know you're top shelf. Wildcat Hayes, we're talking about Chuck Hayes, could be the first man in SEC history to have over 800 rebounds and 300 assists. A great all-around player.
Wild crowd here in Chapel Hill, Kentucky, North Carolina, next on CBS.
CBS sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by the Lexus December to Remember sales event, now through January 3rd. Dickies, a legend in work. And by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here.
First at 4 with Rich Noonan and Stephanie Fisher, Atlanta's only 4 o'clock newscast.
It's the 20th anniversary of the Smith Center, and during that time, Billy, over 5 million fans have watched Tar Heel basketball, another 21,000 watching today. Tubby Smith, eighth year at Kentucky, off to a 4-0 start. His lineup, Randolph Morris and Chuck Hayes. Hayes averaging a double-double. The backcourt includes Azubuki, Rondo, the freshman, and Patrick Sparks, transfer from Western Kentucky. There's Roy Williams, been 15 years at Kansas, came home to North Carolina. Some believe this may be a Final Four team, and here's his lineup. In the front court, Sean May and Juwan Williams. The backcourt, Rashad McCants, Jack Emanuel, and Raymond Felton. McCants averaging 19 points a game. Billy, North Carolina 5-1 on the season. Kentucky running the table so far at 4-0.
Well, a little different type of competition for both of these teams. And what's going to be very interesting here is to see the youth and inexperience of Kentucky going up against a team in North Carolina that now looks at itself as a very experienced and polished team. How well will the young players react?
North Carolina beat Indiana Wednesday night in that ACC Big Ten Challenge in Bloomington. It was close, 70-63. The Tar Heels committed 23 turnovers while Kentucky beat Tennessee Tech Tuesday night at Rupp with a 52-point second half, 92-63.
Well, North Carolina is forcing 23 turnovers a game on their opponents. That'll be really important to watch how Rondo and Sparks handle the backcourt situation.
Sparks handles the tip. We're underway at Chapel Hill. Rondo, the freshman, handles the point for Tubby Smith.
Good aggressive man-to-man by North Carolina to start.
Felton nearly the steal, out of bounds.
That was the first indication for Felton today that he has a very difficult time getting that ball with his left hand with that wrist taped up as it is.
Yeah, he sprained that left wrist against Tennessee back just before Thanksgiving, Billy, on November 23rd. He's going to have it wrapped tight, we understand, 4 to 6 weeks.
Now there's the first example when you start talking about inexperience and youth. Felton going against Rondo. Rondo not strong enough to fight his way through that body to go get that ball. Turnover, 5 second count.
Keep your eye on Felton, how he can dribble with that left hand. They feed it down low. May in traffic. Good defense by Kentucky. Blocked away. Here come the Wildcats. On the break, 2-on-2. Little floater off the glass, and the follow would not go. Big rebound. Williams underneath for the Tar Heels, and North Carolina wants to run.
Azubuike probably should have given that ball up and gotten it back.
Williams lobs it low. May. Oh, nice give and go. Williams for two.
Be a great matchup today with May and Hayes, both extremely powerful, both very experienced, outstanding college players.
Boy, Billy, Williams shooting 60% from the floor. Understand why with nice shots like that. Inside, overshot by Morris. Here comes May with the rebound.
Second close-range shot. Nobody back on defense. Bad defensive balance. Now, when you bring a young team into Chapel Hill to play against an experienced North Carolina club, you cannot let a quick run get away from you. Tubby Smith can't go too long before getting a timeout to calm his team down.
Big question was, how big would the stars be in Kentucky's eyes? Four freshmen, and they lost those three starters from a year ago.
Kentucky has won four straight against North Carolina. Three of those four are blowouts, one of them being the second biggest defeat North Carolina's ever suffered on this floor. So they have some tradition going, but most of those key players have graduated.
You saw Kentucky has missed their first three. And how about that baseline up and in?
Tubby Smith off the bench, starting to walk up and down right now. He knows his team is going to take a while to be as good as they can be because they are so young. Double down, tough shot.
0 for 4 is Kentucky.
Beautifully
finds the seam and May with the flush.
And here comes the timeout. You cannot wait for TV timeouts when you get in this kind of situation.
What a run by North Carolina to start it here at Chapel Hill. 8-0 Tar Heels.
I want you to take a look at Felton on this break, how his head, after the rebound, if we have it right here, how his head is going to fake everybody out. Now watch, he's going to be looking one way, and boom, fires that ball cross court for the layup. Little double team out front.
Rondell, the freshman, out of Louisville, Kentucky.
Nice drive.
Azubuike rejected underneath. Mays playing strong both ends of the court for the Tar Heels, but there was the Wildcats pick a pocket.
There was Felton again. Now, I give the guy a lot of credit for playing with that wrist taped the way it is, but he cannot get quick control of a basketball. Second time we've seen it today.
Azubuike, 1 of 4 on the bucket, and there's a bucket and a foul.
We're really seeing experience over youth here early in this ball game. And sometimes, and there is a great jump stop. Manuel, the experienced player, primarily known for his defensive prowess, all ACC defensive player last year. But he does have that ability to understand what is a good shot for him.
First foul of the game called on Chuck Hayes. And that will send Manuel to the free throw line.
Had 14 against Southern Cal. An up and down game where Southern Cal thought they could come in here and run with North Carolina. And found out otherwise.
3-point play for Janky Manuel.
See if Rondo can start to penetrate with the dribble. Don't want to pick it up out there.
May stepped in. Trying to get that ball away.
What Rondo's going to have to do against Felton is to penetrate with the dribble. He's trying to start the offense so far away from the basket that the passing lanes are not there for him.
Billy Łukasz Orbzut from Poland at 7 feet, 270 pounds, already in this game. Has played very few minutes in these opening couple of weeks of the season, already on the court for Tubby Smith. Rondo, the penetration,
nice.
And the bucket.
There it is, the dribble penetration. He's got to take that challenge and go right through it.
So strong off the dribble. Felton saves it in the corner.
Hayes with a great play that time defensively, coming from behind to take it away from Felton. Again, Felton is so great with the crossover dribble. But again, and I don't want to harbor on this much longer, he has a very difficult time making that transition with that left hand being the way it is.
Turnovers, 2 apiece here in the early going, coming up on the 16-minute mark of the first half.
Obzut, nice half hook, but not there.
Off the mark, far to the right. Here comes North Carolina. Felton to the corner. A chance.
Did you see where McCants went on that semi-break? Right to the far corner three-point line. One of the best perimeter shooters in the country. Somewhat of a delayed fast break, but he's waiting out there with nobody to guard him.
McCants with 5 points, and North Carolina made six straight shots from the floor. From the corner, Kentucky tries to counter. Sparks off the mark. Here comes the break. Manuel up and in.
Beautiful pass by May. And here's where the experience and the ability to play in the SEC is going to be helped by playing a game like this against North Carolina for the likes of Rondo and Sparks, for that matter, even though he had experience at Western Kentucky.
Hayes kicks to the corner, and a turnover, the third for Kentucky. And a timeout in Chapel Hill, 15:45 remaining in the opening half. So far, all North Carolina. North Carolina with an early 12-point lead on Kentucky. And Billy, the Tar Heels shooting 88% from the floor.
Well, as I pointed out at the start of this game, we're looking at a very experienced team. What is different in college basketball this season is that a lot of the power teams have junior and senior players. We haven't seen that in a number of years in college basketball. And when you go in and try to come in with a young lineup against players that have been around, been together, and certainly have the talent that North Carolina has, it can be a very difficult situation, particularly early in the ball game. Let's see if Kentucky adjusts.
As mentioned, four freshmen for Tubby Smith on that roster. Losing those three starters of a year ago, Gerald Fitch, Eric Daniels, Cliff Hawkins, those three combined for 40 points a game.
And they were 62% of their points, 43% of their rebounds, and 66% of the assists. So that's losing a lot.
Blocked away underneath. Third try for the Tar Heels. Williams, tough shot. Sparks rebounds. Baseline. Sparks coast to coast. The high floater and a foul underneath.
Normally out of control dribble like that, particularly when you leave your feet, is going to cause for a charge. A good job by Sparks. Find some open room.
Well, last season, the Tar Heels led in three categories: points per game, McCants, rebounds, May, and assists was Raymond Felton.
First time ever in the conference history that points, rebounds, and assists were run by three different players on the same team.
Sparks, a 62% shooter, makes his first point. Sparks transferring from Western Kentucky, had a set out last year, Billy. Had a coaching change there and thought, you know, always wanted to play at Kentucky and made the switch.
His stats so far are kind of interesting. He's shooting 40% from three and shooting only 62% from the four or from the foul line. You would expect a Kentucky shooter to be one of those 85 plus foul line players.
Williams, who played 5 minutes, baseline and a block underneath. Trying to clog up that baseline.
Bobby Perry with a foul inside from Durham Hillside High School nearby. Understand he has quite a contingency here to watch him play.
Just down the road from Durham, North Carolina. And checking in is David Noel, also just down the road from Durham.
Noel, a very strong athlete. Zone defense now by Kentucky. Out of bounds situation. They better be aware of McCants, who will look for room.
Felt long jumper in and out and underneath. Morris had it. Quick hands and the top of the rim by Marvin Williams.
Now, two of the top freshmen in the country, Williams and Morris. That time Williams got the better of it.
Billy, such a strong rebounder. He's averaging over six boards off the bench. There's Perry with a little side push shot. Wouldn't go. Rebound North Carolina.
I watched him in practice yesterday. A very attentive young man. He's going to be a great player here at North Carolina. Push that time inside, but just too strong.
Williams with three buckets, 6 points. And North Carolina owns the paint here early.
Well, it's just a more mature athlete.
Boy, smothering defense.
Well, let's see Felton on that dribble.
Tips it up and a foul over the back. Over the back.
You don't see McCants miss many of those. Rebound toss out by Morris. Not aware, but there's Williams right inside. Boy, he goes up strong for a young man.
6'9", 230. You see the Band-Aid above his left eye. Suffered a cut against Indiana, 4 stitches. He went in, had it sewn up. He was on the court in no time.
Yeah, one of those stitches inside the eye, as you pointed out earlier. Tough shot by Azubuike. Was 1-for-11 from three to start this season. He's got to take better shots than that.
The block on the baseline. Well, national championships, plenty to go around. UCLA under John Wooden's guidance, of course, dominating that category, Billy. Kentucky with 7, North Carolina with 3.
Kentucky with 13 Final Fours. North Carolina leads that department with 15 Final Fours. So incredible tradition between these two schools. Stay in the zone, just trying to go ahead and slow this attack down a little bit.
No call, strong, and the bucket.
Wow. Noel on the inside again. We're looking at kind of men against boys down on the inside.
Kentucky in a drought over the last 2 minutes and counting.
You know, one of the things that really surprised me in the North Carolina-Indiana game was that the young players for Indiana, particularly on the inside, did a terrific job blocking out. Well-schooled, well-taught. And they took North Carolina out of the running game that we've seen North Carolina have so far this year and we're seeing here again today.
Williams goes out. The fine freshman from Bremerton, Washington.
And what it all means to me is I can't wait to see Santa Clara someday.
Indeed. Yeah, that upset loss to start the season, then went off North Carolina and won the Maui Invitational. Wake-up call.
Hayes that time just reaching back with his hand. Kentucky needs right now all the help they can get. Cheap little foul call there. Tubby should be upset with that. Let him play a little bit, particularly with the score where it is.
Hayes picks up his second foul. Kentucky now with 6 turnovers. North Carolina has turned it over 3 times.
Kentucky back to the man-to-man defense right now. Just trying to find something to slow the pace of this game down. Defensive transition. Again, Mike Davis's team really did a good job against North Carolina the other day, and that's something so far has hurt Kentucky. Zone out of bounds.
Felton to Williams, down low on the block. Now they kick to the corner. Good ball movement by North Carolina. McCant squares, fires hard off the rim. Kentucky with the rebound.
Good job by Bradley picking up on McCant that time. Just to alter that shot somewhat.
Ramel Bradley has it picked. McCant. Showtime.
Well, the freshmen are really being taken to school here today.
Crawford from the corner. Boy, no shots going down for the Wildcats.
And you don't want to take that shot. What you want to do is use as much clock as possible, slow the game down, take North Carolina out of their pace. 3 seconds made. That time. Just to alter that shot somewhat.
Ramel Bradley has it picked. Showtime.
Worked in high school, it worked in all-star games, but
sure.
It does not work here. You're up against a little more superior athlete with much more experience.
McCants on that preseason Wooden Award watch list. That's a pretty big list in the preseason of about 50 around college basketball. Crawford, baseline dribble drive, up nice. And in. So Joe Crawford, a freshman for Tubby, with a bucket, his first out of Detroit, Michigan. Quickly transition down the court. May try to run it down, but out of bounds. It's going to be Kentucky basketball when we come back. 24-8 Tar Heels. Let's flash back to the 1993 title game. Michigan's Chris Webber appeared to travel. And then as he comes down court, Billy called the timeout. Wolverines did not have a timeout left, and they were charged a technical foul. Tar Heels went on to win that game 77-71.
Donald Williams, who had the great Final Four experience with his outstanding outside shooting. I'll never forget Chris Webber leaving the arena that night with that towel over his head.
And the Final Four in St. Louis, March Madness spills over a little bit into April. The second and the fourth. Of course, the title game Monday night, the fourth in St. Louis, and who will it be?
Well, St. Louis was a pretty good place for Kentucky when they had a Final Four there, and Joe Hall's club marched right on through, beating Duke in the national championship.
As a Boogie looking for a little bit of a breathing room, Bradley expires in a three. Ramel Bradley, freshman from New York, on the board, a three-pointer, 24-11, Tar Heels.
Packing things back inside right now. Williams probably should have taken that jumper right away.
Contact underneath.
Helene Morris put the hammer on him. One of the things that surprised me about Morris a little bit, only coming into this game, he's only had two blocks. Very surprising for a guy his size. Very powerful young man.
6'10", 266, out of Atlanta, played his high school ball last year at Landmark Christian High School. 23 points, 16 rebounds, 8 blocks, Billy. Something else.
But we're on another level
yes.
right now.
Williams with 6 points, 2 rebounds.
North Carolina and Kentucky prior to this game both getting to the line very well against their opponents. Crossover jaw, beautiful job.
Azubuki, you're right, the crossover was a killer. Felton to the corner. Williams, three ball on the way.
Going.
Nearly did fall. Got the double bounce off the iron. Here comes Azubuki once again. On the drive, attack, got it.
North Carolina forces your drive to the baseline. Bad job, and Roy Williams up, very disgusted with his team in the last two plays. Very poor weak side defensive help on the drive to the baseline, something that Dean Smith started many years ago, and North Carolina probably as good as anybody in the country at forcing your baseline, but that getting good weak side help. Two plays in a row, they didn't get it. Roy Williams a little hot right now. Kentucky doing a nice job getting back after that initial onslaught.
Substitution, Quentin Thomas is in, number 11, the freshman from Oakland.
This is Crawford's first time to the line this year.
0 for 1. A couple of quick buckets, though, for Crawford. Trying to bring Kentucky back on a 9-1 run, Billy, over the last minute 15.
Thomas, who started his first game out in his hometown when Felton was ruled ineligible to play that opening game, so back out on the court now, a little different in regard to experience in that point guard position with Felton out of the game.
Wildcats have picked up the defense. Morris.
And see the difference also in the fact the structure of the game. Nice drive.
Azubuki missed the layup. Williams underneath the rebound, tied up, jump ball.
Azubuki really taking the ball well to the hole. Good time to, this is a nice move by Tubby Smith. Pick up full court now with Thomas in the game, but Bradley with a foolish hold.
That will be his first.
But I think you'll see more and more this year if Felton goes out of the games, teams will press North Carolina. Because there's a big drop off there in experience in the point guard position. Morris takes a break, so you have Hayes and Morris down on the bench right now. Hayes not off to a big start. Kind of a star role player.
Bobby Perry checks back in for Kentucky as Thomas brings it across midcourt. Coming up on the 10-minute mark of the first half.
See where he is trying to set up an offense similar to what happened to Rondo early in the ballgame. Way too far away from the basket.
Well, again, Kentucky picking it up defensively, pushing the Tar Heels out. They own the paint the first 5 or 6 minutes. Look at Manuel. Wow. The iron and the rebound.
How about that?
Aline.
He has about a little over 9 foot reach and was able to go way up there, pick that one off. That was a bad shot by McCants. But what's happening right now with Thomas in the ball game, North Carolina is not getting set up in a good half court sets. They end up taking a bad shot.
Substitution for Tubby Smith. Crawford goes out and Patrick Sparks back in.
North Carolina team coming into this game shooting 48% from the floor. You don't do that taking those kind of shots. And you don't rebound well normally against those shots. Good cross court.
Sparks for three. Had a good look on the backside rebound. And the Azubuki could not get the follow. Manuel then stolen. Now picked up by the heel. Wild action as Thomas tries to slow it down to the corner. And a foul on the drive.
Yep.
Well, you break it down by conference. The ACC was 7 in the coaches' poll. Big East 4, SEC with 4.
Well, it's the first time in ACC's history they've had seven teams in the top 25. The Big Ten has done it twice. But the ACC playing extremely well. Virginia with another win last night against an Auburn team that could cause some problem in the SEC.
McCants, the free throws, 65% shooter. 8 points for McCants, and there's that ACC lineup in the top 25. Wake, Georgia Tech, Duke, the Tar Heels, Maryland, NC State, and Virginia at number 25.
Virginia preseason was picked to be eighth in the conference. Here they are finding themselves in the top 25 in the country.
9 points for Rashad McCants, the junior from Asheville, North Carolina.
Of all the Kentucky players, although he threw that one away, Azubuike has to remember who he's throwing the ball to. That is not Daniels down inside. Last year, that pass would have been caught and probably put away for a basket. Understand who you're throwing it to.
Good point. That's Sagari Alin out of the Bronx. 7'3", sophomore, still trying to find his way for Tubby Smith. Thomas, nice spin.
Mm-hmm.
From the corner.
Foul on a three.
That will send Williams to the free throw line.
This year in the early going, against good competition, particularly what they faced out in Maui, North Carolina shooting 50 more free throws than their opponent. Always a good sign when you can get to that line. Tubby trying to get the referees to equalize things on both ends.
76% free throw shooter is Jawan Williams, already with 8 points. You know, he hired or at least worked with a personal trainer during the summertime. His big issue was strength, yes, but flexibility as well. He's moving up and down the court pretty well today.
We mentioned Tubby and Roy at the start of the show, and as I said, they don't need any second name to go with both of those. In 99, after Tubby won the national championship in 98, he faced Roy Williams, but Roy was at Kansas at that time. He beat him 63-45 in Chicago and then beat him again in the second round of the NCAA tournament, 92-88 in overtime, eventually losing to Michigan State, but two big wins over Roy that year.
Williams will take a break, Billy, with 9 points after knocking down those free throws, make it 10. So he's in double figures with 8:55 left, and this crowd at the Smith Center is up. Defense is the calling card for Roy Williams.
That was a much better help by May that time, and Manuel going on the floor.
Well, they're dusting the floor. Here comes the young freshman, Quentin Thomas, spinning, contact, and he'll draw the foul.
And there is a high school play. What you have is a backcourt performer that has to understand, unless you can take it all the way to the hoop and finish, pull up at the foul line and distribute the ball. Now here he goes, looking to finish, no place to go, nobody to rebound, mental mistake.
No, Billy, a lot of people said this young man has great talent, but he's playing too fast. Explain that.
Well, he doesn't really understand the pace of the college game and where he used to be able to get by with that on the high school level. Now there's a guy just as big, just as strong, just as fast, waiting for him. Manuel with another nice piece of defense.
Morris had a good look, couldn't get it to go. May the rebound. Here comes Thomas. Well, he is quick. Tar Heels slow it down a bit with McCants at the controls. Puts it on the floor.
Boy, look at how you have to respect his jump shot, which gives him the opportunity to blow by in the drive.
Thomas, nice to Manuel underneath baseline. Boy, it's tough going down there.
And here's the experience. Pull the ball back out, get in some kind of a set. Manuel would have had an easy layup, but he didn't look the ball into his hands on that pass.
Six on the shot, five on the shot. McCants with three, with two. Couldn't get it away.
Well, I'm going to give Kentucky a lot of credit there. They knew what McCants wanted to do. They really crowded him, took away the jump shot.
There's a timeout. Roy Williams and the Tar Heels doubling up Kentucky. Billy, we look at the game summary. North Carolina, 30-15. They're shooting 50% from the floor. How about the 20 points in the paint?
Well, doing a fine job down there. May getting good position in there. And when you take bad shots on one end of the floor, and we saw that McCants when he took the bad shot, that takes away your opportunity to score in the paint. Nobody in position to rebound, nobody in position to get points in the paint, and not going inside. Matter of fact, neither team has done a very good job feeding the ball inside. Most of North Carolina's points in the paint have come from their ability to either drive by or get second chance points.
Juwan Williams leads North Carolina with 10. McCants has 9. And Adebuki with 4, along with Crawford off the bench for Kentucky.
Emmanuel really sitting down defensively. Why, he is such an outstanding defender against guys of multiple sizes. Here he comes across the lane. Great anticipation.
Emmanuel trying to split the seam and lost it off his knee.
I didn't say he was a great open floor ball handler. I said he's a great defender.
Yeah, he was all ACC defensive team last year. Yeah, they get 5-6 points from Jack Emmanuel. I think Roy Williams is happy with that.
Sparks has got to be ready to shoot on that ball that comes out to him. He can't wait and hesitate.
Morris is tied up and a whistle. Sean May picks up the foul.
I mentioned about Morris not being a shot blocker, at least statistically coming into these games, but he has been to the line a lot and shooting over 74%, which is a good sign for a big man.
Morris, a 73% shooter, misses the first. He'll get another.
I watched him in practice on that free throw line. He's got a lot of different motions. It's not one singular motion on the shot. Many times that gets you in trouble. Watch him. He'll go up, he stops, and takes another motion. He needs to have a more fluid stroke than that.
Belton brings it down. Quick kick to the corner.
McCants feeling a bigger man on him. Wanted to keep that ball and drive by. Kentucky back in that 2-3 zone again.
Inside May. High up the glass.
Nice.
And Aline at 7-2 or 7-3 went up high on the top rung.
Nice job by Morris, though, against May, who normally has very good and strong hands.
Rondo trying to penetrate.
Too much side to side. He's got to try to take that ball down in the lane some.
Wildcats drop it low. Morris nice. Squares up and hits a sweet J. Randolph Morris on the bench, averaging 10 points a game. His first bucket. Oh, inside. Tied up on the baseline dribble by Morris. His second foul.
Good strong drive by McCant. You see that bounce pass inside. Morris comes over to help. McCants, remember last year, had that brooding game over in Lexington, Kentucky. Probably, as I said, the low point of his career because he has been outstanding. We've seen him have some just sensational games. Maybe the game he played against Connecticut in here last year in the game down at Georgia Tech were two of the finest individual performances of the year. So the young man has a lot of ability.
Marvin Williams, Billy, goes out. Juwan Williams back in for North Carolina. And McCants will get another in double figures with 10. Coming off a 19-point game against Indiana and made them both.
Now this North Carolina team right now is about 9 deep. The one position that I don't think that they're as solid as they'd like to be, at least at this point in the season, is when Felton goes out. But they're very flexible at all the other positions.
Morris is out for Kentucky and Wukosh Orbzu is back in, a 7-footer. So they are playing big right now, at least Tubby in Kentucky. Under 6 minutes left. 32-17, been all North Carolina. Crawford working on McCants. 6 on the shot clock. McCants caught it in the corner, starts the break for North Carolina. Pull up, Felton. Tipped around, May stripped.
Azubuki got it on the way up, good block.
They'll get complete coverage from all of today's games and read Greg Doyle's take on the hottest topics in college basketball. It's all at CBSSportsLine.com.
Felton hasn't hit any jump shots so far today, but he's improved his outside shooting. Great steal!
Rondo for the freshman with a nice pickpocket.
Felton lost concentration there. Good job by Rondo.
That's his 13th steal of the season. Turns it into 2. McCants on the wing.
Kentucky stays in that zone, very aware of McCants' jump shot. Boy, that's way downtown.
Got it! Oh!
He shot one in Indiana the other night. It had to be 30-some feet, but he's got incredible range and a very soft stroke.
shooting 52% from behind the arc in this early part of the season. Opens up a 35-19 lead.
You'll see this incredible range way on out. No way for the zone to get out and make that play. And he loved it.
Felton whistle for the foul. That will be his second. And so Rondo, Rajon Rondo, the freshman from Louisville, high school All-America a year ago, Oak Hill Academy.
Good rebound by Williams. Boy, he goes up strong.
Good-looking young player. And that time, a little fast, is Raymond Felton. Now coming up on Singular at the half, Brando, Timmy B, and Seth Davis will get you updated on other action going on around the country. And Seth will tell you who and what to look out for on this year's Road to the Final Four. That's all coming up on Singular at the half.
Felton, a 61% free throw shooter. And, you know, I really admire him because we saw yesterday in practice, it doesn't take much to hurt that wrist of his. So he's playing with a lot of toughness. But it does take away his ability to really shift gears and move that ball in the left hand, which he is so good at.
Substitutions.
I mentioned about his outside shooting up around 44% now from three, where he's been a 31% shooter in his career. It's been the one weakness that he's shown.
Felton with another, this time makes it. He's on the board, his first point. Now, Felton had a little trouble yesterday. Got that hand slapped a couple of times and had to take a walk to the bench just to shake off the pain.
Here's North Carolina. They've shown their point zone some today as well. Bradley, pretty good outside shooter, as Ibuki is as well. We need to get Bradley in a position. There he is.
Shoots and fires a three.
North Carolina didn't do a good job there recognizing what players on the floor more than likely would take the shot from outside.
Couple of three-point buckets by Bradley, and here comes Bradley again on the break. Look at that, the trailer!
Well, you think these freshmen don't have some potential. Great job by Bradley.
Billy, it all started with Alleen's defense.
Yep. Lee is so tall. He's a factor again.
Two on two, Rondo lets the traffic go by. Oh, the left-hander. Three buckets, 6 points for Rondo. All of a sudden, a comeback by the Wildcats.
Great job by Kentucky to get back in this ball game.
Cuts it down to 10.
North Carolina getting nothing inside. Alleen doing a real nice job back there being a factor with a long wingspan.
Hands are up with a foul on Bradley. Ramel Bradley, his second, and a timeout. 3:24 before the half, and Kentucky making a run at the Tar Heels. Well, let's revisit the Singular Raising the Bar game analysis. Billy, what do you think?
Well, without question, DeCance with 14 points, he's all there. These two coaches have shown very well. But where did Wildcat Hayes go? He has not scored in his ballgame.
Well, McCants has scored 7 of the last 10 points for North Carolina. 14 leads all scorers. Jawad Williams with 10. But Kentucky has made a push behind the three-point shooting of Ramel Bradley. Has a couple of threes for 6. Rondo, the freshman point guard, 3 buckets, 6 points.
And I think Alleen's ability in that zone with that wingspan has caused some problems for North Carolina. They're not getting the ball inside at all. McCants back on the foul line. I tell you, you have to go out and respect his jump shot at almost any range. And when you do that, he's quick enough to make the adjustment and go by. And that's how he's drawing some of these fouls.
McCants perfect from the line, 4 for 4, make it 5 of 5.
Last year led the ACC in scoring, all conference first team. This year, preseason, Chris Paul, player of the year. Preseason player of the year pick, but McCants right there on the preseason all conference, as was made.
One more for McCants with 16 points.
7 of 7. And how about 17 first-half points for Rashad McCants? And Billy, North Carolina has just lived at the free-throw line this first half of play. They're 13 of 15 as a team, and Kentucky has towed the line 6 times, made 2.
Kentucky, coming into this game, had been living on the line, shooting 60 more free throws than their opponents. Level of competition, a little bit different than North Carolina, however.
Nice save in the corner by Rondo. 3 minutes left before half.
Both freshmen in the backcourt out there right now. Tough to make Lean make that kind of play.
Rondo.
Push off.
1 second on the shot, hit the front of the iron, the follow, and the bucket as Abuki with 8 points.
Did not give up on the play. Good job on his part. Ball, Aline doing such a job covering everybody on the inside. Williams thinks he can go by him with quickness, but Aline stays right with him.
Felton has it on the wing, gives it up. Scott, now the corner, Williams.
There's Aline again, another great defensive job on his part.
Really, his defensive presence in the last 5 minutes has really helped Kentucky get back in it. Long free ball, trying to bank it off the glass. Felton with a rebound.
Got a bye with a push on that play.
2-on-2.
One extra dribble by Felton, putting down in no man's land, picking up that charge.
Next Saturday, doubleheader action here on CBS. Kentucky, Indiana continue their rivalry. Then Stanford takes on Michigan State. All the action starts at 1:30 Eastern, right here on CBS, home of the men's NCAA basketball championship.
Well, one of the best games I've seen this year. Tom Izzo's team doing a terrific job in Durham against Duke. That Michigan State team will certainly be in the hunt for this national championship. Stanford down a little bit. Whole new cast of characters there. It'll be interesting to see how Michigan State continues to improve.
Felton has gone to the bench for North Carolina with his third foul and a whistle before the shot.
Rondo recognizing right away Felton out of the game, puts the ball on the floor and penetrates.
Quentin Thomas, who just checked in for Felton, picks up the foul, his second. And so Rondo will go to the free throw line.
You mentioned Rondo played at Oak Hill. It's been a good spot for Tubby Smith. Jules Kamara, Ron Mercer, Keith Bogans, Cliff Hawkins. They really have had some outstanding players. Mercer, of course, under the Rick Pitino era. But Tubby has looked at that school that is producing an awful lot of major college players. Ranks as the best in the country.
1 for 2 was Rondo. He has 7 points in his opening half. Under 2 minutes. May comes up to help out. He's up against Aline, the big 7'3" post player. From the corner, long jumper, and it's down. Big shot by Melvin Scott, the senior.
Scott, last year against Kentucky, was probably the most solid of the North Carolina players in that ball game. He's lost a little confidence on his jump shot, but certainly capable of throwing him down.
Tough defense in that corner by the Tar Heels.
All out trapping defense.
Inside, Aline could not handle it. Billy, that's a tough play underneath. And here's so far so good, Billy, major coaching changes from a year ago.
Now there's three guys right there, all of which could be looking at Final Fours. Bill Self, Kansas, Bruce Weber. Had a little touch there. What did he have? A little problem with his health early on the year, but he had no problems with his health in the Wake Forest game. Boy, Illinois played a great, great basketball game.
Boy, Kansas has not missed a beat. Bill Self doing a nice job in place of Roy Williams. He spent 15 years in Lawrence.
It's interesting that Self was previously at Illinois, so
they move
connection
around.
All the way.
2 on the shot clock. Moss. Desperation shot
over the
whistle over the back.
That's good defense when you can take a team right down to the shot clock and then they have to take a bad shot. Nice to have that man back in college basketball. Lon Kruger, who, again, we talk about Illinois, a guy did a terrific job there in Florida. Thad Matta moves over to Ohio State. He's got some work to do there. Sean Miller, who came from this league down in the Atlantic Coast Conference, moving up. Some shuffling around, but outstanding coaches right there that I'm sure can get it done.
You saw George Thompson the third at Georgetown.
That seemed to be a fit. He didn't do such a bad job at Princeton either, though, where he had played and played so well.
Patrick Sparks back in. A couple of missed free throws, but Noel pulls down the miss. Underneath, May, no way. Loose ball, Thomas. And a fresh shot clock, McCants. Looks down on the low post, May rejected.
Tell you, Aline is getting it done.
Oh, wow!
Noel, a terrific leaper. He's able to keep that up, but Aline is putting on some kind of defensive show here. Took a terrific play to overcome it.
2 seconds separate shot clock, game clock. Big three buried by Azubuike. He's in double figures, Billy, with 11.
He's had an excellent first half on both ends of the floor, playing extremely hard.
Final ticks is Thomas. Spins, dishes, McCants, squares and fires and hits! And it's a three ball.
Nice spin. Beautiful. Oh, they waved it off. Good hustle by Thomas. Good recognition to go back there and make the steal.
A 20-point first half for Rashad McCants, North Carolina. 47, Kentucky 32. And a good call by the officials. The ball's clearly in the hands as the clock ran dry. 20 for McCants. Jawad Williams with 10 for North Carolina. Azubuike, Billy, with 11 for Kentucky in the first 20 minutes.
On a live call, look for the light. That determines, and you can see the light is on, the ball in the hands, and on a live call, there it goes.
The first half complete at Chapel Hill, 47-32. Back to New York, and here's Tim Brando.
Thanks, Craig. Coming up on Singular at the Half, we'll get you caught up on all of today's scores and highlights. And Seth Davis will give his outlook on the season after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular, raising the bar.
Welcome back to Singular at the Half. I'm Tim Brando, along with Sports Illustrated writer Seth Davis. We're only a few weeks into the college basketball season. There have already been quite a few surprises. It looks like it's going to be another unpredictable season, but we're going to put you on the spot right now to make a few predictions.
On this spot?
At this very moment.
At this very spot. And I know that you keep track of these
things. I'm writing.
The pressure is really on today.
As you speak, I'm writing.
All right, Tim, I'm going to start off by giving some sleeper teams, teams you might not expect a lot of the season, but I think will be a factor at season's end. Creighton, I believe, is going to be a top 25 team possibly next week after their 6-0 start. I really like the Arkansas Razorbacks. They're playing Illinois later on today. That's obviously going to be a huge test, but I think they're ready to take a step up in Stan Heath's third year, largely because of that guy, Ronnie Brewer, a 6'7 point guard, Jonathan Monica. This is a very athletic team, not very big inside, but they can really get up on the break. Here are some new faces to look at. Freshman and junior college transfers. That's Taj Gray from Oklahoma. Sean Singletary would not have been on this list at the start of the year, but he has been impressive for the Virginia Cavaliers. But to me, there's no freshman in the country with more pressure on him on a top-ranked team than Daniel Gibson down at Texas. And boy, he's shown so far that he can handle it. Leads the team in scoring and assists, 47% from three. He's got a chance to pull a Mike Bibby and lead Texas to a national championship. Ooh. He's that good, and Texas is that talented. My all-excitement team, not necessarily the five best players in America, but five guys you really want to see. And, Tim, I know you get to go to the games for free, but if you were going to pay to see one guy in America, he should be Nate Robinson at the University of Washington. They list him at 5'9". I think that's when he's wearing two-inch heels. Very athletic guy. Gets above the rim. 54% from three and a real high energy player, and that is very important for Washington because they really get up and down the floor. They cannot afford to be low on their energy in any given game. Make or break. These are guys who have had expectations in the past and maybe haven't quite lived up to them. Bracey Wright at Indiana is a guy really still looking to find his role. Same thing with Salim Stoudemire at Arizona. But Paul Davis is somebody who has really worked hard at Michigan State, developing his strength and his ability inside. But Tom Izzo is still complaining that he is not competitively ready night in and night out. He went for 17-10 against Duke, but was 3-for-8 from the foul line. Those are exactly the kind of of things, Tim, that Paul Davis needs to improve on for Michigan State to get to the Final Four.
You're still transcribing. Now, after saying all of that, who do you like in the Final Four?
Final Four. All right. Well, I reserve the right to change this list, but let's start.
You do.
I do. Between now and Selection Sunday. Let's start with the Fighting Illini. That's an easy choice. Not only what they did to Wake Forest, but they trounced a pretty good Gonzaga team last weekend. Wake Forest is my number two, although I consider taking them off. I don't mind them losing in Champaign, but to get embarrassed like that was very disappointing. North Carolina, I think, is very strong. They're only going to get better. Raymond Felton's got to get healthy. Marvin Williams will improve. And the Syracuse Orange men, not just talented and experienced, but that 2-3 zone is very difficult to handle in the tournament. And my national champion, at least of today, I'm sticking with the North Carolina Tar Heels. The Sports Illustrated rejinx, we got him on our cover, but I think the difference is going to be freshman Marvin Williams. I think he's going to be taking major steps as the year goes on. But, Tim, really the story in college basketball this season, parity at the top. You've got 7 or 8 teams who not only have a chance to win the title, but have the right to consider themselves favorites to do so.
Now, we're saving this tape. We'll see how right you are 4 months from now. A reminder, be sure to tune in tomorrow for the NFL on CBS regional action. Many of you will see San Diego and Denver battle for the AFC West lead, and it all begins at noon Eastern with the NFL Today. Singular at the Half continues in a moment. Welcome back to Singular at the Half with the score in Chapel Hill, North Carolina, leading Kentucky 47-32. Tim Brando joined again by Seth Davis of Sports Illustrated. Seth, I've seen Carolina in person. They are really, really good.
I told you they look like a national championship team. Let me say this about Rashad McCants. Say whatever you want about the kid. There's not a coach in America that wouldn't love to have McCants on their team. I think, Tim, he's the best player in college basketball, and I love the competitive fire that he brings to this team.
All right, let's get you caught up on the scoreboard. Our other game on CBS today, bit of a surprise. Indiana defending national champion UConn, and it's Marshall Strickland with the wide open three, and then UConn freshman Rudy Gay positions himself for the putback dunk, and Indiana's Mike Roberts. What happens? Well, you're going to see right here. Oh, the iron unkind.
Oh, I've been waiting for that, Tim.
Then comes the putback. Yes, the Hoosiers taking the lead. And really, the turnover is the problem for UConn.
9 in the first half, 40 in their first two games. They don't take care of the basketball well.
All right, the other team from the Commonwealth, Quick Ricks Cats of Louisville, sprinting out early against Lafayette. Lorenzo Wade with nice form here with a nylon song. Brad Giannini finding Brandon Jenkins for the baseline. Jay, Cardinals up 22-4. Francisco Garcia, he needs to play better.
Well, he's only shot 26% from three. A very good passer of the basketball. I'm sure that will improve, and it helps to play lesser competition.
Yeah, the Leopards shooting a paltry 22%. Miami, Frank Haith, the former assistant to Rick Barnes, their coach. But I think for Billy Donovan's team, this guy, David Lee, had better finally live up to the pre-advanced billing.
Pretty good offensive player, needs to improve his defense. It helps they've got some very good freshmen down in Gainesville.
Guillermo Diaz, one of the guards for Haith, knocking down threes. And then Florida's Corey Brewer would answer, 21-15. And Height nails the three-point J here. Their guards, Miami's, have scored 26 of its points, and they're only down by 2 at the O'Connell Center, just underway, second half. Well, the Fighting Irish do have a basketball coach, Mike Bray, and his team taking on Michigan today. Brett Petway goes to the basket for the slam to make it 12-9. And then off the turnover, Dennis Lattimore will take it up for the slam. This is a Notre Dame team that you really like. You think they've got a nice shot if Chris Thomas can play well.
Absolutely. They got great guards. I love Chris Quinn. But Michigan really needs a win here, Tim. There's Chris Thomas there on the dunk. But Michigan on a three-game losing streak. They are getting their leading returning scorer, Lester Abram, back today. He's played 7 minutes in the first half.
All right. A reminder now for lightning-fast scoring and play-by-play for all of today's college games, go to CBSSportsLine.com. Switching gears now to some news in college football. Moments ago, the University of Florida officially announced on the school's website the hiring of Urban Meyer as head coach. We'll have a lot more on that later. A reminder, coming up later at 6 p.m. Eastern, it's the SEC Championship presented by Dr. Pepper. Number 3 Auburn tries to stay undefeated and keep its national title hopes alive against 15th-ranked Tennessee. And coming up next, one of the greatest rivalries in all of sports. The tradition continues with the 105th edition of Army-Navy. That's coming up right after basketball. Thanks for watching Singular at the Half. The second half of Kentucky and North Carolina is coming right up.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular, raising the bar. Get ahead of the weather with Gene Norman's Storm Tracker 46 forecast tonight at 11. CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by the new Chevrolets. 10 new cars and trucks in 20 months. An American revolution. Ritz. Nothing feels like a Ritz. And by Icy Hot Patch. It's icy first to dull the pain, then hot to relax pain away for hours.
Halftime in Chapel Hill, 47-32. North Carolina on top by 15. Rashad McCants had his way. Billy in the first half, 20 points. Hit 3 of 5 from behind the arc.
And conversely, on the other side, Chuck Hayes did not score for Kentucky. Something they're going to have to get him in the offense early, and here they go to him in the low post.
Did not take a shot. Abazuki got it. 3-point shot down, so a good start for Kentucky.
That's 14 for Azubuki. Not only 14 points, but he had 4 steals in the first half. Great job on his part. North Carolina turning it over, and that's something else that was surprising in this first half. Both teams a negative assist turnover ratio. Kentucky 6 assists, 12 turnovers. North Carolina now 8 assists and 13 turnovers.
Tar Heels had 23 TOs against Indiana Wednesday night at ACC Big Ten Challenge, but still managed the 7-point win.
I think a lot of that has to do with Felton's inability to play 100% with that left hand.
Morris at the free throw line, soft shot.
Second time today he's taken that little jump shot. He's got an excellent release. And as you pointed out, nice soft shot. And there again, can't use the left hand. Rondo reaches in. Rondo is going to be one of those defensive players that's going to come up with a lot of steals. He has excellent anticipation, but even more so, he has those very long arms. And even though he's at a certain distance from you, you underestimate the reach.
Second foul on Rondo, and all of a sudden that 15-point lead trimmed to 10. Off the mark. Oh,
right,
there was
the face.
Slap across the chops.
Of course, it's tough.
Sparks spinning.
Nice.
How about the give underneath? Azubuki with 5 quick ones, 16 points. It's down to single digits.
Rondo again causing trouble with a reach in with those long arms, almost coming up with another steal. You know, when you play a game against an experienced team on their court, you really have to be careful of that big burst at the start of the second half. So Kentucky doing a real good job here, not only not allowing North Carolina to have the burst, but staying right there with them.
7-0 run to start this second half by Kentucky. May tracked on that baseline. Gives it up to McCants. Works on the wing.
Got a switch right now. Azubuki on May, a little small.
Contact in the paint, and we're going the other way. And Billy, we look at the halftime numbers. Turnovers even at 12 apiece.
Yeah, that really surprised me. Neither team doing a good job assist turnover ratio. And what North Carolina didn't do a good job there, there was the switch. May was inside with Azubuki, and McCants never got it into him.
Sparks. A little strong on the three, but the rebound and a fresh clock goes to Kentucky. Contact. May had an arm up. Crowd wants the foul on Morris, but May gets it. It'll be his second.
I don't know if that was a wise shot by Sparks. You know, they've got it down now to the situation where single digit. You don't want to take that long outside shot before your rebounders can get in position.
So Morris with the free throw out of Atlanta, Georgia. High school All-American. 6'10", 266, big body.
And if you're North Carolina, I think you want to get the ball down in May. Morris has 2 fouls on him. Try to pick up the third here early because the young guy's getting some confidence.
6 points now for Morris.
Again, there are those long hands by Rondo.
6-point lead. It was
15 at the half for North Carolina. Made Love, nicely done. McCants got it to roll in.
That was a beautiful catch. And McCants was able to make the adjustment in the air as he looked for the rim and then found where he was located.
22 for Rashawn McCants. 21,000 and change here at the Smith Center, and Chapel Hill on their feet. Sparks guarded by McCants.
Official using his head down there to keep the ball almost in play. You see the steal from behind. Pow.
Good header.
Yeah.
Chuck Hayes with the ball in his hands. Did not take a shot in the first 20 minutes. He's on the floor, sharing some time there with Sean May. And Billy, with the conclusion of today's game, we will select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game from each team. Chevrolet will make a contribution to each school's general scholarship fund, a tradition now for 30 years.
Shot clock down to 10. Now let's see if Rondo gets the ball in his hands, if he understands that he's got to initiate a play very quickly. Morris doesn't come. Rondo doesn't come to the ball. Leaves it up to a freshman big man to make the play.
Wild shot. May had it. Here comes Felton. May takes it and pops the rim.
Second time today we've seen somebody go for the dunk to eliminate the block. Good job by May.
Only a second bucket. Had 9 rebounds in the first half for Sean May. And quickly, Felton pulls up. Jumper around and out. Tip. Kentucky has it. Here comes Rondo. Sparks up and in.
Boy, what a great job by Morris to eliminate any defensive help.
Tempo is quickened. McCants on the drive. Inside. May with back-to-back flushes.
That was not a pass. That ball was stolen. And May was at the right place at the right time.
So May with a couple of quick dunks. 6 points. 10 rebounds for May. And that's his 21st career double-figure rebounding game. Morris up the back of the iron. Here
Morris
comes North Carolina.
Morris a little tired right now. He's going to have to come out of the ball game.
May on the trailer. And just when Kentucky had pulled the string tight, the Tar Heels loosen it up. 55-43.
Morris really trying to get some air right now. North Carolina wisely goes to some trapping.
Well,
got hit in the eye.
Next, join CBS Sports for one of the grandest spectacles in all of sports. It's all guts, all grit, all glory. It's the Army-Navy game, and it's coming up next here on CBS.
The young men that are seniors at West Point have never won that game, have they? I think they lost every time, so you can imagine the emotion in that locker room.
Morris around and out. Sean May has scored the last 6 points for North Carolina.
Well, one of the reasons that he did that, and he's in such better shape than he had been in his two previous years. Of course, 1 year missed almost the whole season with injuries. But he really forced Morris to get up and down the floor. Took a lot of wind away from him. That foul shot probably helped Morris in the fact that it slowed the game down.
The lead is 11 for North Carolina. Raymond Felton dribbling with that heavily taped left wrist. Turn around. Rejected.
Nice.
2-on-1 is Kentucky. Hayes gives it up. Sparks scoops it up. Got the bounce.
There's Rondo again anticipating almost with a steal. I'll tell you, that really hurt Felton.
Yep, it sure did. He is on a knee.
Yep, he's in. And we knew after watching practice yesterday that this was bound to happen to Felton. That wrist is very, very sore.
Billy, we saw the exact same thing yesterday right here at practice. Amazing.
Now, North Carolina is going to have to decide what they're going to do because it's going to be a while before that wrist is really healthy.
Timeout at Chapel Hill. North Carolina and Kentucky.
We're going to see what happens right here as Rondo will run through this ball and cause a problem. Right into that left wrist, almost identical to the play we saw yesterday where Felton got hurt. That is going to be a constant problem for North Carolina till it eventually heals. He may have to take some time off. Tough young man, and as we mentioned, the MVP in Maui, despite the fact that he had that hand hurt in the Tennessee game, which was in the semifinal.
Quinton Thomas now running the point for North Carolina, and a whistle away from the ball.
That's a hold on the inside on the cut. Solid screen inside. Williams and McCants operating.
Third foul on Morris and a timeout. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA men's basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station. Well, we flash back to San Antonio, 1998, side of the national title game. Kentucky battled back from a 41-31 halftime deficit to Utah. Rick Majerus, the Wildcats went on to win 78-69. They claimed their seventh national title. And what a debut it was for that man.
Well, they were the comeback kids. I'll never forget that comeback against Duke, which put them in a position to go to the Final Four. Tremendous move. First year you're at the helm and you take it all the way. He's picked up right from there, though. He's now 19-4 in SEC tournament play. So you can, you know, one of the toughest leagues in the country. He has really got some runs.
Understand Felton, who had that ball jammed into his sprained wrist, will return. McCants with 22 has it. Now Thomas, nice good feed underneath. Good. Williams spins it up for a bucket. He has a dozen.
That was a good thinking play by Thomas to realize as soon as he caught the ball that he had a pass to make rather than hesitating. Made the play.
So many of his points come low block, spinning, look at that, back door jam. Pops the rim is Hayes, he's on the board.
Williams didn't realize there was a back screen coming. Now lean with those long arms again, another steal.
Over 8 feet on the wingspan. Sparks gives it up. And a three ball goes down for Azubuike. 19.
He's having an all-star performance in this game as Azubuike on both ends of the floor because he's been matched up defensively with McCants a lot.
Kentucky trims it to six. McCants slapped away. Aline again, his defensive presence.
And again Aline.
7-3, 271. Getting it done defensively for Kentucky. Now Sparks with 14 minutes left. Abazuki on the dribble, the drive, baseline. Closed down, Sparks helps out, squares up. Tough front of the rim.
Thomas needs to hit ahead. He needs to hit ahead. See, he tries to do too many things.
Too fast.
The pass was for McCants and a hit ahead. Another turnover for North Carolina. Big drop off when they go Felton to Thomas.
The three ball, too strong. Tip controlled by North Carolina.
So where is Thomas go?
Melvin Scott has taken the warm-up off.
Melvin Scott is a two-guard, not a point guard, but Roy Williams may have to start getting more play back there because I don't think Thomas is ready yet.
All day to shoot on a rattler by Marvin Williams.
Can do it on the glass and step out.
Three-pointer for Williams, five on the game. Missed shot by Kentucky.
A smart play by McCants. Pull the ball back out. Make sure this time down the floor you get a good shot.
9-point Carolina lead, led by 15 at the half.
There was the back screen that time, not recognized by Williams. It goes right over the top. That's Hayes' first basket of the game. Quite surprising that Kentucky could be in this position with Hayes not having a stellar game.
Had foul trouble early in the first half, and Felton has checked back in at the point.
So now you have Felton and Scott in the backcourt together. There was a back screen. North Carolina trying to get the same thing.
Felton with the crossover and the pass to May.
Yeah. He throws Alim that time by taking the ball and staying down low. Alim couldn't go ahead and cover both he and May.
Sean May, 5 of 9 from the floor, 10 points. Double figures for May. Hayes, the push shot wouldn't go, tipped around. Manuel has it for North Carolina. May on the trailer, and they'll slow it up. Quickly inside, May spins it up and in.
That was a great, great look ahead by Noel.
Sean May, the former Indiana Player of the Year, who chose North Carolina over Indiana.
Well, because of physical problems that he had 2 years ago and the fact that he never was in this great a shape last year, we're seeing an entirely different player. Really doing a good job getting up and down the floor, beating big men down the floor that are going to play him this year, so it's a real asset.
May has scored 11 of the last 16 North Carolina points. He has a double-double, 13 points, 10 boards, and the crowd is up at the Smith Center.
Tubby talking to his young guards about getting back on defense.
North Carolina has stretched that lead back to 14, and now, Billy, the coach's poll will be a new number one this week.
Well, you know what? Ric Flair said you can't be the man till you beat the man, okay? And who beat the man? That was Illinois, beat the man number one, Wake Forest, and I have to feel that Illinois deserves to slide on by Kansas and be in that number one spot.
Under 12 minutes left.
Dangerous pass.
Bradley in traffic. Too strong. May, another board.
And look at May taking off. Look at him taking off.
Bouncing twice. It falls off the rim. Fresh clock. Boy, he is moving up and down the court, offensive and defensive.
That's going to be a grab. Rondo grabbed the shirt. Now, it was not an intentional grab.
We'll take a break. 11:33 left.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four is sponsored by Coca-Cola. Let's make it real. Dickies, a legend in work. And by the new Singular, raising the bar.
Sean May showing us that he's not only in excellent shape, but he's got great skills running the floor in North Carolina. Doing what you should do for a big man who'll run the floor, and that's getting the ball at the end. Terrific job on his part.
Sean May was 1 of 5 in the first half, and he has exploded here. 5 out of 6 from the floor, so he's taken over the scoring load for McCants, who had 20 in the first 20 minutes.
McCants has been very quiet here in this second half. Azubuki's got to get a lot of credit for that. He's been matched up with him a lot. Kentucky now back in the zone in the out-of-bounds situation.
As you see, North Carolina on an 8-0 run over the last 3 minutes.
A hold inside again. Freshman not realizing with those screens down and low, they can't hang on.
Crawford picks up the foul. Joe Crawford, his second.
North Carolina, like many teams, love to use that solid screen down on the baseline.
Pass inside on the pivot, thrown away.
Noel did what Manuel did early in the ball game, did not look the ball into his hands looking to shoot before he made the catch. Nice dish.
Long shot. Kentucky's missed their last 6 from the floor. Felton. And a whistle.
Now, was that Crawford that pinned that ball up on the backboard? He got in the air.
Well, when Bob Dylan sits down for his first television interview in 19 years, you've got to hear what he's got to say. Check it out Sunday on 60 Minutes here on CBS. The foul, Billy, on Rondo. That's going to be 4 on Rajon Rondo.
Well, Felton took it down inside. He has a good ability to finish, and there was an incredible job by Joe Crawford going up there and showing you what kind of leaping ability he has. Rondo has to come out. Sparks in for it.
Felton 1 of 3 from the free throw line. Only 1 point in this game.
and he can be valuable with just one point, unlike a lot of guys that play that position and occupy the ball a lot.
He's the number one assist man of the ACC, averaging 8 per game. Sparks down low, double team, kicks for 3. Got it.
He was due.
Patrick Sparks with 9. He's a gym rat, Billy. His dad, Steve, coached him in high school, and a whistle before the shot.
Here we see some surprise teams. Santa Clara has to be at the top of that list with their terrific play. Illinois Chicago almost taking Georgia Tech down. Davidson goes on the road, beats Missouri, plays a fine game against Duke. A number of teams maybe outside the major power conferences that are already making a run.
Now the road to the Final Four has begun. 4 months from today, a champion will be crowned in St. Louis. Sparks with plenty of time on the shot clock. They've worked it to 16 in the corner. Crawford back to Sparks. Abazuki.
Oh, great defensive play that time by Manuel.
Well, he's really faced him up. Noel has it, and the breakaway.
Azubuki was being blocked off. Manuel on that last play against Azubuki, as fine a defensive one-on-one maneuver as I've seen in a while, because he was in tough position. Azubuki, who's had a fine game, made a nice reverse, and Manuel was right there with him to set up that fast break situation.
Second foul on Azubuki with 19 points.
And we see a lot of two-sport stars. Of course, Julius Peppers, who's having the incredible month of November. I see he was picked the NFL Defensive Player of the Year with his incredible performance. We remember what he used to do on the basketball court. Well, just the opposite. Was an outstanding high school football receiver, has been strictly basketball here at North Carolina.
Now, he turned down scholarships, Billy, even here at North Carolina, walked on, and now is a scholarship player for Roy Williams. Sparks weaves it inside. Nice. Morris, oh, missed the layup. Under 10 minutes left, Scott. Felton back to Scott,
this
pulls the trigger.
He is not confident with his jumper right now, probably because coming off the bench, there are certain guys that can't shoot well coming off the bench. They need to be starters. Scott normally can bury that shot. You can tell he's pressing. Look at him walking down the floor right now, wondering, how can I miss a wide open jumper? He's got that in his arsenal.
Sparks picks up his 4th. Rondo has 4 for Kentucky. Felton really the only North Carolina player, Billy, with foul trouble with 3.
Well, with a working margin right now, I'm kind of surprised that, not for long, that Felton's still on the floor. And here comes Thomas in just as I say that.
Marvin Williams sets the screen for McCants.
That zone packed way inside right now.
So McCants would launch deep and hits.
And that was Morris out there on him, shoots it over a 6'10 player.
25 for McCants, he's 4 of 7 behind the 3-point line.
Good hedge move that time by Williams.
71-54. Abazuki got it. Nice floater.
He's made outside jumpers. He's taken it all the way to the hoop, and there's a beautiful floating short shot.
One-man show. Long jumper off the mark.
Williams really didn't have it set in his hands, did he?
Kentucky has made a couple of runs at North Carolina. This time, Abazuki off the mark. Under 9 minutes left. Inside goes Williams.
Oh, how about that? Was Hayes that got that one
from behind. Crawford on the trailer. The baseline closes in a hurry. Wow. Abazuki.
Oh,
got it. Watch out. Kentucky has that ability. 24 for Azubuki.
Big turnaround there. North Carolina with an easy lay-in. A terrific defensive play by Hayes. Azubuki has been carrying his club offensively.
24 points. At 11 at the half. Long 3.
Scott again cannot hit his jumper.
Loose ball tip. Williams and a foul.
Aaron Morris gets a little tired. Like all young big players, he has a tendency to reach. And that's when you pick up the cheap foul.
A timeout. Fourth foul on Morris, and we'll be back to Chapel Hill. ...14-point lead for North Carolina. Rebounds dominated by the Tar Heels. Azubuki with 24, 10 of 18 from the floor, Billy. McCants with 25, he's hit 7 of 14.
That's a career high for Azubuki. He had 23 against Georgia last year. But he also, in this ball game, has 5 steals and has played outstanding defense.
By the way, they changed the foul. Azubuki picks up his third, so wipe away the fourth foul on Morris. Jawad Williams at the free throw line.
Has had double figures in every game this year. 23 against Southern Cal, where he was 9 for 11 in a game that was basically run up and down the floor. A lot of good looks for him.
15 points, 6 rebounds for Jawad Williams. Bradley trying to penetrate the floater. Up high, got the bounce.
Rondo and Bradley both going to be outstanding guards for Kentucky. Bradley probably the better outside shooter. Rondo with that ability to make a lot of steals. Where's Williams going? Wow. He's shown us that he can step out and take the jumper. There he tried to penetrate from almost 16 feet. Has to understand there'll be somebody there trying to draw the charge. Defender waiting on him.
First foul on Williams.
You get the feeling Bradley thinks he can take Thomas anytime he's guarding him. Not going to be long. Thomas and Felton coming back in this ball game.
Thomas on the wing. Manuel with 7 minutes left. Does Kentucky have another run? Turnovers an issue for Kentucky today.
Well, both teams have turned the ball over. North Carolina, as I said before this game started, forcing 23 turnovers per game. Continuing to do that. Good anticipation by Manuel. There's the steal by McCants, so they're doing it in all different ways. There's Noel with a good steal with anticipation. Good job, North Carolina defense.
That is Roy Williams' calling card, Billy. I mean, Carolina's defense, they force an average of 23 turnovers so far this season.
I think North Carolina has really, you know, looking ahead, as difficult as the Atlantic Coast Conference is going to be, North Carolina is going to have to figure out what do we do when Felton is on the bench. Because I don't think Thomas is ready to take up the minutes necessary in a league that has such great guards under pressure to be able to keep them in their offense.
First miss by McCants from the free throw line, now 8 of 9. Crawford, the crossover, hangs on that pivot, and a whistle. Sunday on CBS begins with 60 Minutes and a rare interview with Bob Dylan, followed by Cold Case, then an original holiday movie, A Very Merry Christmas. That's Sunday on CBS, America's most watched network.
This outstanding recruiting class that Tubby Smith has put together with these freshmen all look like they can be part of outstanding teams in years to come here for Kentucky. Crawford, Bradley's played well, Rondo. And obviously Morris down in the middle.
Crawford with his second, missed them both. May had it, lost it, and Felton covers up. Kentucky 6 of 14 from the free throw line.
Not getting there often, and when they do, not executing.
Williams needs help.
Bad foul by Bradley that time. You've got the clock as your teammate. Commit one way out there. Williams had nothing to do with the ball.
Well, let's take a look at the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. It's reboundings and those points in the paint. 40 over 22 North Carolina controlling the boards for a complete game. Stats go to cbs.sportsline.com. Ramel Bradley, his third personal foul. Yeah.
Good bloodline, Jawad Williams. Billy, his mom, Gail, played hoops at Cleveland State. Second one good.
Well, on the floor right now, you see two seniors, three juniors for North Carolina. I think that's been the difference in this ballgame every time they've been challenged. Roy Williams gets that lineup back out there.
Crawford, long range three. Joe Crawford, 7 points from Detroit, Michigan. 77-66, a lot of time left. Coming up on 6 minutes remaining. Manuel. McCants in the corner. Trying to spin on Moss.
Nice defense. And good decision by McCants not to take a bad shot.
Felton, little push shot. Rebound, May. Monday on the Late Show, Dave welcomes Renee Zellweger. And later this week, don't miss Tom Hanks, John Travolta, Jerry Seinfeld. What a lineup. All Dave, all this week on CBS.
May go into the foul line. We saw his dad, Scott, former National Player of the Year and those great Indiana teams in 75 and 76. I heard Quinn Buckner the other night say, our 75 team, although it did not win the national championship, was a better team. People remember Scott May got hurt. They lost to Kentucky that year. And I was thinking back, Greg, who were the best teams I've ever seen that didn't win a national championship? And that Indiana team in 75 be one of them. UCLA in 74 with Walton when they got beat. I think that Vegas team in 91. Ohio State in 62. North Carolina with Michael Jordan, Perkins, and those guys in 84. And then maybe Roy Williams' Kansas team in 97. They got beat by Arizona. You start thinking about great clubs that weren't able to get that magic ring. It's kind of interesting.
May missed them both. Bradley fouled out. He picked up his fifth, and so Rondo, the freshman with four fouls, checks back in for Tubby Smith. Crawford, long range short.
Good anticipation by May.
Here comes Manuel on the break. High off the glass and a whistle.
And that's, is that Rondo's fifth? Depends on whether they call it on Crawford or Rondo.
It will be on Rondo.
That's his fifth. He's out of there.
So they've lost Ramel Bradley and now Rajon Rondo.
Well, what you have to figure right there, again, a lack of inexperience. If you're Rondo as a junior or senior, you realize Manuel is not good on the break with the ball. He was in a bad position to take a shot because he doesn't have a good left hand. You have no reason to foul him. Let him take the bad shot, get the rebound, and go down the other way. So it'll all come with experience and knowledge of the game. He's got the talents physically.
Patrick Sparks checks back in. He's in foul trouble with four as the free throw falls through for Manuel. Rondo out, had 7 points, Billy, in the first half. Did not score in the second half of play.
You know, I look at his mentality to be more of an assist man than being a scorer. But with his defensive ability to steal, I think he'll score off his defense.
79-66, North Carolina.
They have not been able to push that lead. They get it up, and then all of a sudden, Kentucky hangs right in there and comes back. Testimony to the tremendous tradition of winning at this university.
Bobby Perry will come in, and Aline will come out.
I should say the tradition of winning at both universities. They both know how to do that.
Jawad Williams is whistled for the foul, his third. 5:12 left on a 13-point North Carolina lead. Chuck Hayes just unable to get on track for Kentucky. Moss has it, long range three.
Wow,
popped it clean. So Moss off the bench with his first bucket.
He surprised Felton that time.
Billy, that was way out.
Yep.
79-69. A lot of time, under five to go. Tough baseline move, falls off the iron. Last touch by North Carolina.
Boy, McCants thought he drew the foul on that drive on the inside. I think he did as well. But no call there. And Kentucky hanging right in this ballgame. This is a huge possession.
May came out to take a swipe at Sparks. Perry has a bookie. Gave it back to Moss. Nice save. Plenty of time on the shot clock.
Oh, big.
Perry buries it. Tough, tough shot.
Can you believe it? Down to seven. Roy Williams. He's wanting to get something down in the low blocks right here. Here comes May. Outsteps. Can't. Nothing there.
Thought about it.
Yep.
Works his way on the wing against Perry. Good defense.
Trying to draw a foul down in there, but Perry does a good job staying with it.
Manuel with six on the shot. High off the glass. May gathers it in. Did not touch the rim, Billy. And the shot clock runs dry.
Boy, that was not only an excellent possession for Kentucky right before this when they had the ball, but not a good possession for North Carolina.
Boys, stick seven around. Points. 7-point ball game at Chapel Hill. Seven-point game, North Carolina, Billy, on top, 3:44 left. Double bonus with the 10 fouls committed by Kentucky. Possession arrow to North Carolina. This is like the third run Kentucky's made in this game against the Tar Heels.
Well, they've made it in this second half with 10 assists and only two turnovers against the North Carolina defense. So they've made good shot selection. I'd let Hayes touch the ball one time at least.
Perry had a good look, but was just short on that floater. Loose ball. Felton comes up with it. Now McCants drives, dishes back. Felton.
Underneath. What a tip.
Williams, the sleeper.
Perfect timing by Williams.
19 for Jawad, the senior from Cleveland.
Here's where Kentucky needs to go back and just slow down a little bit. They're trying to get it so quickly. Let Hayes touch the ball. Instead, he pushes from behind.
Well, next, join CBS Sports for one of the grandest spectacles in all of sports. It's all guts, all grit, and all glory. It's the Army-Navy game, and it's coming up next here on CBS.
Craig, when's the last time you have seen somebody hanging in a ball game that's been out-rebounded by 20 rebounds, and the fouls so far are 23 out of 32 for North Carolina and 6 for 14 for Kentucky, and is still hanging in this ball game? How many more runs can they make now that Roy Williams is keeping his solid five on the floor most of this time, not doing any substituting?
Couldn't grab the rebound, and another whistle. And remember, too, Rondo is out with fouls, and so is Ramel Bradley. So that bench, or at least that point guard position, has been depleted.
And when this comeback situation, Aline, who had such a good first half defensively, basically is not the guy you want to have out on the floor right now, because what you have to do is get some good ball handling and some wide open looks. Sparks has been very quiet.
McCants makes another. He's now 9 of 10 from the free throw line. Substitutions for Tubby Smith. Randolph Morris comes back in along with Joe Crawford.
Very quiet here right now.
Very quiet. 28-point game for Rashawn McCants.
And he does it in a quiet way. You know, he just stays in his own pace. I think if you're playing against him, you've got to take him out of that pace that he likes.
David Noel in for North Carolina. Jawad Williams out. Under 3 minutes. As a bookie. He's been tough from behind the arc. Nearly stolen. Sparks leans. Didn't get the bounce. Loose ball. Here comes the Tar Heel. That's Noel behind the back. Sparks. Good defense. Strips it away.
Not a good decision by Noel to try to be the man taking it down the floor. That was blocked by McCants against the 6'10 Morris. How about that? McCants goes right up and takes it with him. Gets a piece of the ball just enough to prevent it from going in. 6'4" against 6'10".
Crawford at the free throw line, 0 for 3 from the charity stripe today.
Hit some nice shots from outside, however.
Big make. Crawford with 8 points off the bench. Played at Renaissance High School a year ago in Detroit. 24 points, 11 rebounds, 7 assists.
And most importantly, didn't lose a ball game.
What a run.
Three McDonald's All-Americans in that recruiting class. Crawford being one of them.
Makes them both.
Picking up full court.
84-74, Kentucky refusing to go away. 2:16 left.
You know, I don't know how Felton catches the ball as well as he does with that cast on there. You know that's got to be a problem for him. You know it gets wet and slippery.
Working with the left hand now. There you go, Billy. It did. It slipped right off the left hand.
Well, he just doesn't have total control. Amazing what he's being able to do with that tape on there.
Army-Navy straight ahead. Chuck Hayes, foul number 4. And this is a game Chuck Hayes may just want to erase.
Well, he's a quiet player and a star player that really likes to play in that of a role player. I mean, last year with the experience that they had and Hawkins running the game and from the point guard position, I think he's much more comfortable. He's probably going to have to step up some this year, make some plays.
Two big misses by Raymond Felton. Hayes puts it on the floor with the left hand, high floater. Too strong, the tip wouldn't go. Loose ball. Hayes, strong, won't go. There's a lid on it. Saved, Crawford.
Has Ibuki down, I think he hit his knee right onto the floor. He's getting up right now. I just think his knee made hard contact with the floor here. There it is.
Or the hip.
He fell right on top of him, did Noel.
You don't want him coming out of this ball game now if you're Kentucky. Not with the game he's had.
24 points. Azubuki, 10 of 18 from the floor. He's hit 4 of 6 from behind the arc. 1:41 left to go. The alley. Oop!
That was Hayes.
So Hayes with 2 buckets, 4 points coming in this second half of play, and a whistle. And I believe Hayes whistled for the foul. That's going to be 5.
He's out of there. It's going to put Felton on the line. You see that alley-oop that went in there. Good job by Hayes. Excellent timing. Used that strong body. Sparks on the toss. Fine play. Now down the other end, Felton goes to that foul line. And we have seen him have trouble. The way he releases the ball with all of that tape has not shot free throws well today.
So Hayes will go out.
He's only shooting 61% on the year coming in. Watch how difficult it is on his, not on his release hand, but on that left hand when he goes to shoot. Just doesn't stay with the shot at all.
Well, you can tell by his facial expression, too. He knows.
Look at Roy Williams.
Yeah.
Roy Williams saying, stay with the shot. He's got to learn to keep that left hand right up there with it. That was a lot better.
3 of 9 for Felton. All of his points have come from the free throw line. Sparks in a hurry. Gives it up to Perry. Azubuki on the dribble. The drive. Push shot short. May, another rebound.
Nice set of hands for May, isn't it? There's that crossover dribble. Good hit ahead.
Noel.
Beautiful pass.
And that could do it. 87-76 with 1:05 left. Sparks has it stripped away. Manuel. Noel. He's ringing the bell.
Manuel today tried to dribble a couple of times in a break and was not successful. That time he gave it up. Cubby wants a timeout.
Back-to-back buckets by David Noel, 10 points. And North Carolina leads by 13. ...55 seconds remaining for Tubby Smith, and we'll send you right after this game to Army-Navy. One of college football's all-time classics. Straight ahead here on CBS, Roy Williams, looking to move to 6-1 on the season. This would be Kentucky's first loss. Perry.
Craig, this is a young team, and I expect them to keep improving as this year goes on as they bring these freshmen more and more into the action.
89-78, and another timeout for Tubby. We'll be back. Well, time to check out the Chevrolet most valuable players of the game, and from Kentucky, hands down, Azubuike. 10 of 19 for 24 points. McCants had 28, hitting 7 of 15 for North Carolina.
Mabe running on that baseline as he has that ability to do.
Mabe for the passing lane.
Alley, oop, Emmanuel drops it in. North Carolina now just trying to run away and hide. 91-78.
Emmanuel wisely giving that ball up to Felton.
North Carolina, Billy, will go 6-1. While Kentucky will drop to 4-1. And North Carolina is going to have a little time off. They've only played two games over the next 2 weeks because of school. And coming up next, Morehead State for Kentucky.
And they're playing a lot at home. That gives them 1,833 wins. Kentucky, 1,880. Number one and number two in all-time wins. I think Kentucky with this young team is going to get a lot better, and North Carolina is going to have to find an answer when Felton sits down.
91-78, the final. Army-Navy coming up next. For Billy Packer, Craig Bowler, Jack, our CBS crew, back to New York, and here's Tim Brando. Timmy?
All right, Craig, thank you very much. We've got just a few